Howdy folks, Chris Gleed here, doing some additional testing with the 2-bit encoder that we've all come to know and love in conjunction with a stock Nintendo inverter board. Got everything pulled out of the cab here because I'm tired of pulling my cabs off the wall and digging around in them and all that stuff. So I've got basically a super gun set up with a Nintendo Donkey Kong DKG4-11 revision 2-board stack. Got a Mike's Arcade Nintendo Edge connector to JAMA adapter going into a retro electronic super gun. So that's taking video out to VGA over there, a Gonbez device to the VGA screen. Now, if you'll notice, the image is flipped as it was in the Billy Mitchell 1.04 and 1.05 videos. So some interesting information that was shared by Christian Pac Man yesterday from the Brasington website. You can actually wire up a switch on the board here and make it switch the orientation, flip the orientation, however you want to call it, how it displays. So what I'm going to do is do a little run with it flipped, how it was shown on the 1.04 and 1.05 video. See if that produces the finger girder that we're all desperately looking for. Certain it does not exist on arcade hardware, but what the hey, I've got all the free time in the world to try to prove Billy's innocence. So please, Billy, if you wouldn't mind, go ahead and fess up. Tired of spending time on this. I'm sure I'm not the only one. I think we'd all like to get on with our lives at this point. In addition, if you see the image that is so coming from the 2-bit encoder RCA output to a VCR, and that pass-through is going to my plasma. The image that's produced on the plasma, not only is it lacking color, but it is getting significantly worse every time I display it on the plasma. Jace Hall touched on this earlier today with a rather lengthy post, but with some extremely valuable and all-encompassing information, things we're both experiencing in our individual testing. And one of the big pieces is that some devices do not like what this 2-bit encoder spits out, and primarily one of those devices, which seems universal, is a VCR. So what you see on the screen here is exactly what will record on a VHS on the VCR. And so far, as he has indicated, and in my testing, cannot get it to record in color. That said, I'm going to take that composite output over to Anchor Bay VP30 video processor, which spits out HDMI after processing it, digitizes the signal, all that good stuff. That'll be coming out on the screen over there that's currently blue. And I'm going to capture while I am playing the game a 60 FPS capture, and if there's any hints or signs of the girder finger and some of these other frames that we are coming to believe is distinctly not arcade signature hallmark frames, then well, we'll see what happens. So I'm going to go ahead and swap it over here, let you see that. Then I'll jump into some gameplay here. And if you notice there, it was black and white for just a moment when the transition took place, and then it went to color. after some form of digital processing or something, who knows. But again, all pretty weird stuff.